Hello and welcome to Learn Statistics class. In this class, we are going to study the statistical concept in simple and more easy way. The topic of today's lecture is continuous uniform distribution. In this topic, we are going to study two points. The arithmetic mean of uniform distribution and the variance of continuous uniform distribution. So let us start with mean of continuous uniform distribution. If x follow uniform distribution over the interval a to b, then the mean of continuous uniform distribution is defined as, mean is given by expected value of x, as we have already studied in the first year of PSC, and which is defined as integration minus infinity to plus infinity x into fx dx. Here, since the variable is continuous, we obtain the arithmetic mean by integrating x into fx. As the variable x follow uniform over a to b, the range of variable x is from a to b. Hence, the limits of integration changed from a to b, x fx dx. We know that fx is the PDF of continuous uniform distribution, and which is 1 upon b minus a. Since 1 by b minus a is constant, we can take this quantity outside the integration sign. 1 upon b minus a, integration a to b x into dx. In the previous lecture, we have already learned the definition and PDF of continuous uniform distribution and the cumulative distribution function of continuous uniform distribution. If students want to learn that lecture, then click on the I button at the top right corner of the screen, and link of that lecture is also given in the description box. We know that the integration of x is x square upon 2. Over the limit a to b. Then put the limit of the integration by putting upper limit first minus the lower limit. We get the mean of continuous uniform distribution as expectation x is equal to 1 by b minus a into upper limit is b, so it is b square minus a square divided by 2. Expand this b square minus a square as b minus a into b plus a divided by 2. This b minus a cancel with the b minus a in the numerator. So only remaining term is a plus b divided by 2. Therefore, the mean of continuous uniform distribution comes out to be a plus b divided by 2. This is the value of mean of continuous uniform distribution over the range a to b. Now move to the second point, variance of continuous uniform distribution. If x follow uniform over a to b, then the variance of continuous uniform distribution is defined as variance of x equal to expectation of x square minus the square of expectation of x. This expectation x is nothing but the arithmetic mean, as we have already calculated in the previous slide. Substitute the value of that expectation x, and which is nothing but a plus b upon 2 square. Here, to obtain variance, we have to calculate the expectation of x square. So, consider the expectation of x square. By definition of expectation, it is integration minus infinity to plus infinity x square into fx dx. As x follow continuous uniform distribution over the range a to b, the limit of the integration becomes integration a to b x square fx dx. We know that the PDF of continuous uniform distribution over a to b is 1 by b minus a. Hence, it is integration a to b x square into 1 by b minus a dx. As 1 by b minus a constant, we can take it out of the integration sign. Therefore, the expected value of x square is equal to 1 upon b minus a integration a to b x square dx. As the integration of x square is x cube upon 3, over the limit a to b, by putting the limits of integration, we get, put upper limit first, hence it is b cube minus a cube divided by 3. Then factorize the numerator b cube minus a cube as b minus a into b square plus ab plus a square divided by 3. factor b minus a from denominator is get cancelled with the factor b minus a in the numerator. Hence, we get the expectation of x square as b square plus ab plus a square divided by 3. This is the value of expectation x square. Now we shall substitute the value of expectation x square in the formula of variance x. Then we get the value of variance x. Hence, variance of x is equal to b square plus ab plus a square divided by 3 minus a plus b square by 4. Now simplify this step to get the value of variance. Take the LCM 4 into b square plus ab plus a square minus 3 into a plus b bracket square divided by 12. Multiply the factor inside the bracket. This a plus b bracket square is a square plus b square plus twice ab. After multiplying by 3 to the second bracket, we get this term. Now subtract the respective terms. 4b square minus 3b square is b square minus twice ab plus a square divided by 12, and the numerator is a perfect square b minus a bracket square upon 12. This is the value of variance. This is the value of variance of a continuous uniform distribution. Hence, in this lecture, we have learned how to calculate the arithmetic mean and variance of a continuous uniform distribution. In the previous lectures, we have learned so many statistical basic concepts and measures of central tendency, etc. If students want to learn all that basic terms, measures of central tendency, etc., then click on the I button at the top right corner of the screen, and link of all the playlist and the lectures link are also given in the description box. If student like this video, then click on the like button and share with your friend. If students are not subscribed to this channel still, then please subscribe to Learn Statistics channel to get more videos on statistical concept, and it will help them to learn the statistical concepts in more simple and easy way. If somebody has a query or doubt regarding the concepts in the lecture, then please comment. I will solve your query as early as possible. In this way, we complete the today's lecture, and we will meet soon with the next concept in the next lecture. We will stop here. Till then, thank you.